And now, the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
That's right, Chuck Man.
That's right, Jay. I'd never call you J-Man. That's right, way too douchey.
That's right, Dan Man.
Hey, J-Man.
You gotta do it just like that. It's the Bonfire coming to the radio series XM 95. We are live on Wednesday. Big J. Oakerson, Dan Soder.
Midweek in it.
Jacob, Christine Lou, White Lou, Black Lou, both here. Jacob, what do you think's going on with possible guest here? We were in the hallways. We were getting so excited because we saw Rob Thomas is here, and then we started doing Rob Thomas impressions for the next 15 minutes.
Not only was Rob Thomas here, Rob Thomas was playing with Chicago.
He was playing with them here?
Yes.
They played? Or did they hang out? Like, they did interviews? Anybody? Lou?
On the list it says performance guests, so that means they must have performed.
Oh, you think they did Rob? You think Chicago's just Rob Thomas' solo work backing band now?
Oh.
Or do you think he sang Chicago songs?
I think he came in to sing Chicago songs. I think they called him off the bench.
Oh, that would be so fucking cool.
But we were,
I want to talk to him about
Lou was in the bathroom with him, right?
Yeah.
Did you pee right next to him?
No, I went really far away. I wanted him to be comfortable.
Okay, good. Well, we have a future episode when we're up in Montreal where we talk about being piss shy. Yeah. But then we started doing Rob Thomas where I can't pee sitting next to him, and then I just go, this won't come out. And then he gives me a second, I go, how about I forget about it?
Let's just forget about it.
And then we just started doing outrageous Rob Thomas, and Jay was doing one that had me. And then Rob Thomas just walked down the hall, and he was like three doors down. Oh, not the band.
What?
I know. I didn't mean to do that.
Good wordplay, 90s.
Thank you.
90s boy.
Hey, what's up? It's Dan Soder. I got a soul patch.
I'm 90s boy.
I got earrings and a soul patch.
I like purple jeans. I'm 90s boy.
Is he going to come in?
He said he should just walk in.
But no one's going to do
Dude,
that.
Dude, if he just busts through the door, that would be pretty badass. Rob
he's
Thomas?
He's not going to come in if it says on air. Should we go sweet someone
check? I told him to.
All right.
He goes, it's 6 p.m., I'm lazy.
It's 6 p.m., and I got to go home. Oh, yeah, boy, boy, boy.
Jacob said he likes cheese.
Wait a second. Black Lou knows all the words.
What?
Look at him mouthing it.
Is Rob Thomas a crossover to the black community?
No.
Was this a guilty pleasure of yours?
I just went to an all-white school, so I know all this
gotcha.
Shit.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Oh,
but I'm still learning about Pantera. Thank you, by the way.
You're welcome, Hootie. Yep. I'll tell you what.
It's Darius Rucker. There is no Hootie.
That was, I looked over. I did not expect to see that. I feel like
just
Lou,
sticking it.
Who's everything about his outfit says he would love this. I don't think likes this.
I don't like this.
Lou is fucking air guitar and legit chords.
White Lou is sitting there like he's sitting through his stepson's piano recital. If he walked in right there, we would look like such assholes.
I have no problem with it.
I only care when I'm sleeping.
Shut up!
Jacob, go stalk him in the hallway.
Yeah.
Grab him by his two hoopy earrings and drag his face in here.
Dude, this girl, is this his wife in the video?
I don't know. Let's take a look at his wife, though. See if that was her outside. Girl's a little veiny in the foot, if I'm being honest.
He looks like my friend Ben Roy from you know Ben Roy from Denver.
Grolix.
He's Grolix. He's on Those Who Can on True TV.
Tomorrow. Oh, you're getting your hair cut tomorrow.
Yeah.
Can we go in the bathroom right now, me and you both, and give ourselves Rob Thomas. We both have a length of hair. We can give ourselves some curly on the outside.
I'll
Rob
do it
Thomas's.
Right now. I'll do the Rob Thomas's.
You want to do Rob Thomas's?
His wife is gorgeous.
Yeah, she's here with him. She is, yeah.
You don't know who watches over who. You don't know if, like, she stops him from getting groupies or if he stops her from getting hit on.
I don't know why he gets a chick like that. They probably have beautiful sex. I wouldn't mind walking in.
My dick's too big for my fucking jeans.
He goes, but my wife can take it.
Oh, yeah. She's from a country where that's the least of her worries. Her pussy's been beaten. It's just huge. Black Lou right now is air making out with somebody in college.
Come on, the
white girl.
What if he kicks the door and goes, take you for granted?
And he's got his hand, he's listening to it on his phone, he goes, I wanna take you for granted. I would quit, I would just quit entertainment and I'd go live in a cabin in Montana. So my mind would be mush.
Remember his fucking gacked up induction of Chicago?
So that's why he was here. Bring that up. Bring up his...
Remember that? He's like, okay.
Did we talk about Chicago's it on the show?
Chicago's got a horn section.
He goes, and, yeah, sometimes I hear horns. Sometimes I don't hear horns. But most of the time I do hear horns.
Sarah? Who the fuck's your Sarah? Who the fuck's your Sarah?
I'm not going to lie. I should have brought a mouth guard. I'm about to wear through my teeth. Anyways, Peter Cetera's here, but it's also like, fuck Peter Cetera. Like, they were good to him. Like, he was good to them too. Like, oh, fuck.
I'm like, Journey did with a Filipino.
Yeah. Do it with me. Chicago, do it with me.
You guys do another white guy.
I go, Chicago, I'll do it with you.
I know all the songs. 25-6-4.
You guys want me to sing?
Here it is. Look, play this. Play this. He's not coming.
Ah, you son of a bitch, Jacob!
I believe it, because by the way, we were getting ready to watch him all coked out on TV.
Man, Jacob, I was like, dude, if he was, I was just waiting for him to be like, hey, what's up, fellas? And we're like, and now, world.
What's up? I'm doing a bonfire with Big J and Dan Soder. It's 6 p.m. It must be bonfire.
He did PayPal.
He goes, by the way, I'm still geeked up. You guys want a fist fight? I take my shirt off. It's my wife. Ah, she's so hot. You're so
hot. She has to suck me off in one of these stalls just to calm me down.
I'm hot.
Tigers out of the cage has to taste blood. Know what I mean, boys? Here, play this, Lou.
Band with horns.
I'm sort of not. Oh, isn't it, Christine? If you go to the HBO, when we played it on the show, we went to HBO Go, and then
no. They erased this.
Oh, they did.
Remember, they didn't put this up. We had to watch it like this.
So let's talk about the kind of stones that these guys have. Their first album was a double album.
It's not a good video,
that,
though.
My friends, is Balls of Steel.
Here's what happened, though. Pause it. You don't have to play because we have to find a better copy. Oh, maybe it's better on the screen up there. But he, whatchamacall, dude, it's like he never stops moving his hands, and he also, the mic is way too low.
He also has everyone...
Instead of moving, he just keeps, he backs away and then keeps dipping down. He goes, also, Chicago had a lot of hits.
And he also...
In the 70s, and then also the 80s.
He asks every single person in the audience if they're a cop. Hey, are you a cop?
Are you a cop?
All right, cool. Yeah, no, never mind. So, man, I barely touched my dinner. I just drank like 17 cups of water.
Hey,
God, I am
Chicago straight band. You guys in the front row. You guys party? You guys party later?
You guys look like
you're staying in the hotel? Are you staying in the hotel?
Hey, you used to work at Interscope? Yeah, I know you, dude. Hey, you still got that guy in Fresno that can drive me up that shit? Oh, God. Is this just me or is it hot in here? It's hot in an arena. It gets hot. I mean, I haven't done an arena in a while, but it is hot.
Is your friend Steve coming? Is your friend Steve coming tonight? The guy who wears like the tight leather jacket?
Nah.
He seems cool. He's a cool guy.
Let's forget about it.
That might...
Rob, I'm actually sober.
Well, then let's just forget about it.
We were saying when you get the piss fear, Santana just kicks open the door.
Well, let's forget about it.
I would have loved to talk to some Rob Thomas.
Yeah, dude, there's so many
fucking
questions.
Snubbed.
Also, I think he would be blown. His mind would be blown knowing that Black Lou is a diehard fan.
Oh, I know. I would
give him one guess. I go, who's a diehard fan in here? And then I would
that just seems mean. Who's the only person who can sing two lyrics of any of your songs?
He goes, Christine.
Black Lou.
No, he goes right to Christine.
Oh, yeah,
goes,
yeah, yeah.
Christine, and she goes, I can. And you're like, God damn it.
She's like, you want me to sing them into your dick microphone?
She goes, testing.
I said, ooh, there's already some goo there.
Yeah. His wife goes, don't eat. Oh, and Fran Drescher was here?
You didn't see her, though? You guys think
that's
if you
weird,
see
I've
each other, you guys would just like David Lynch both vanish?
Yeah, I've never seen them both in the same room. What if, would you be like, if you found out she was your mom, would you be like...
I'd be like, I have a mommy.
Yeah. All
right,
yeah.
You would just turn right to her. No more affection for the lady who raised you
in a wheelchair bed. I know, it doesn't work like that.
Yeah. But it's Fran Drescher.
But I'd have a mom again. She's still alive.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you told me you were a Patriots fan, and now you say you're an Eagles fan, so you will flip-flop pretty quick. Yeah.
Everyone knows parents are like football teams. That's why I love the 49ers so much. It represents my dad. I could have gone to the Broncos with several of my mother's boyfriends.
Oh, they were big Broncos fans. But you half root for the Broncos.
Not really. I mean, they're like, you know, if the Niners are out, yeah. But I won't, like, it's always the 49ers. When I was a kid, my uncle would take me to... They'd play him in the preseason, and he would take me preseason football, Niners, Broncos. I'd always wear Niners shit.
Me, you, and Che gonna go to that game in Philly.
Yeah, fuck yeah, dude.
Absolutely.
And Madrigal. I bet Al Madrigal will fly out for it.
Yeah.
That'd be fun.
He's on the TV now. Speaking of your dad, Gary, today's his birthday?
Yeah. It would have been 68 years old.
Oof.
Yeah.
My dad turned 68 like 2 days ago.
Hey.
That's weird.
Christine, do you live in the headphones?
Who's dad?
The loudest thing I've ever heard.
Who's dad birthdays?
Who's dad birthdays?
Yeah.
Gemini's.
Yeah.
My dad never took a sip. Died 5 years ago.
Yeah, I go, no, he didn't. I met him at your after party.
Oh, yeah. His soul's been dead for years. So.
Other Gary.
Other Gary.
Well, he's just a Gary.
His birthday's Groundhog's Day.
Is it really?
And that, there's some funny ironic that I would constantly go outside and relive the same him not showing up. He's like, I'm sorry, I was doing news in Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania.
Not even. Every time the alarm clock went off, he went, I'm just going to hang out. It's even worse. He
goes, I when my alarm clock went off every day, instead of I got you, babe, it was, what I'm feeling like, Dad, is to borrow the car keys.
Oh, God, Cats in the Cradle.
And the Cats in the Cradle.
You wake up and you're like, it's coming today. He's bringing me that new mitt.
Sun arrived just the other day.
You know, I met Josh Chapin. The kid that this song's about.
You did tell me that.
Yeah, he was an intern at Comedy Central.
It's actually about him?
It's like, based on...
Was Harry Chapin's dad, was he like, yeah, I was kind of a dick to my pop?
Well, and the behind the music with Harry Chapin, he says, like, you know, it was about being on the road all the time and not seeing my son.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, I was out, because he toured like a motherfucker. He played, like, 200 shows a year.
Oh, the Chape? Can't the stop Chape? Him? You dude, can't slow him down.
Yeah, not, I mean, I know he got over for Cats in the Cradle, but he was a great storyteller. Go back. There's some good songs. I'm a Chapin guy. In fact... We're doing Gary birthday music all day. I'm putting the Chapin in, but I'm not telling you which Chapin I'm going with. It's you're not Cats in the Cradle.
You're going other Chapin?
No, I'll go B-side Chapin. You want to go Circles? We can do this all day. You want to go to Sniper? I don't give a
shit. But you got me on Chapin.
Well, I'm Chapin all day.
I will submit to your Chapin knowledge.
Hold on. Jamming out to some Matchbox 20. And then Roger, Notorious RGA, who is a diehard camper. The top camper, he said, fuck him. He works security for a Matchbox 20 show, and we were told not to bother his non-pass-wearing fiance, but weren't told what she looked like. Oh, that's kind of fucked up.
They said, don't bother her.
But also, why isn't she not wearing a pass?
But you don't know who she is.
Yeah, that's like, well, then you see her and you go, oh, I know who you are.
If I was running security, I'd be like, Google image, make sure you know what she looks like, and don't bother her.
Oh, see, if I was running like, security, if I was running security, he goes, just don't bother my fiance. You'll figure it out. And then I would just try to figure out who it was and then ask that girl to suck my dick to get backstage.
You go,
and then he goes, excuse me. I'm like, well, I didn't know it was your wife. You didn't tell us who she was.
You go, you want to meet Rob
Label Thomas? This bitch.
You want to go, you want to meet Rob Thomas? How about you, give me a little HJ here in the corridor? She goes, that's my fiance. You go, well, I found you.
Ooh, well, good. You might as well get out of your system before you're married. Flop. Yeah. Just, like, make your own dick meat, slap your leg.
What do you got, clam hands?
I want to know when this was, because he's been married since 1999.
Well, Roger, tweet back at us. And let us know.
Give me your hand, make it real. Or else forget about it.
Santana comes out the side room. How does he always show up at the right time?
My funky donka senorita.
Yeah, but I think that's like, yeah, that's kind of a shitty move where you're making the entire fucking security staff be like, guess. I mean, I had that moment with Kenny Rogers. Where he showed up and I was like, you can't get backstage without a pass. And he goes, I'm Kenny Rogers. He's like, you sure as shit are.
Let me tell you something.
But he just popped up from his passenger seat.
Dan, you got some attitude.
And he goes,
coming
you got
at
to
me the wrong way. Learn how to act.
Right. Sarah McPants is right. If Rob Thomas did come in here and start kicking some ass, Black Lou would jump on his side.
If he came in, he's going to beat the shit out of us. And Black Lou would help? Oof.
What if that's why he can write songs like this? Because it's like Mraz. He just has a crazy violent side.
Do you feel like what happened here is Sarah McPants loves Rob Thomas?
Yes.
And she was like, guys, just so you know, he'll beat the shit out of you if he came in here.
Guys, it's like cool that you guys are making fun of him. And it's like, you know, Roger's kind of piling on at this point. But also, like, he'll kill you with his bare hands. So, oh, is this an acoustic?
Lou.
Hit me when I'm all alone.
Sometimes.
What a lily.
What's more what's more fun doing the...
this guy's awful. A real Sally.
Dude, I really hope he comes in now.
Me too. I'm going to call him a queef and play this in the background.
How much I loved his first album.
I'm gonna ask his wife if she got a badge on.
I'm gonna heart punch him while this song's playing in his headphones.
And we're going like this. Hey lady, you can't be in here without a badge. Who are you?
I'm gonna go punch him in the off button.
Yeah. He goes, it's 3 a.m.
It's 3 a.m.
And you just hit me in the solo plex.
Sorry, I was aiming for the heart.
Why are you so oh, dude? Lou, too, would just fucking shank you with a pencil in your neck.
His best friend is a black guy.
Yeah.
Lou would side with Rob Thomas immediately. Without a doubt. Do you know the amount of high fives he would get at his college reunion?
Oh, and fist bumps? And back high fives?
Bruh!
Yeah, that was righteous.
Heard you fucking wingman Thomas in an ass whoop.
Heard you help Bobby Tom out in this situation.
Heard you help Rob Tom out.
Hey, what's up with Bob Tom?
Bob Tom.
Bobby Tom took one for you, bro.
Oh, Bobby Tom came in. You guys had to roll your whole staff. He's pretty sick.
Might as well call it Matchbox 21, because that day you were on their side.
Black Lou, you're... They call him Black Lou also. Yeah. Black Lou.
Oh, this carries over? I'm gonna just tickle that acoustic.
What happened, Jake? He left. He's gone. He's out of the building.
Yeah, he had a car waiting for him at 5:45.
Oh,
took
good
off.
Good Lord.
I tried.
What did he have to do so important?
Just
plow that chick again?
Yeah, for the billionth time.
Oh, you think, how many knuckles in you think he is right now in that car? You think he waits till he gets home?
Yeah, dude, they've been married for 20 years.
Or you think he greases up the Uber? Are they?
Yeah.
No.
He has been married in 1999.
99, so 18 years.
Oh, you think he cheats?
I think they just talk to each other.
I only cheat when it's raining.
Marisol Maldonado, she's gorgeous.
Let me
good
see.
Job, Rob Thomas.
High five.
I heard she has four nipples.
That's not true.
I'll break her down. That happiness
is a method it's a hand job in an Uber.
It's the only way we keep our marriage alive
is public sex. Stopped raining.
Then I hire a couple of construction workers to pee on her. I said, maybe.
He's all sweet about it.
This 3 a.m.
Well, what's the new? Because we're gonna talk about another song that we were loving in San Francisco.
Oh.
Which is one of the best songs of all time. But it's like, what's more fun doing? Is it more fun going, forget about it? Or is it more fun going, hit it, Lou? You know, there's a singer named Rob Thomas going down. He's got a wife looking fine and a band called Matchbox 20.
I got a lot of good hits out there.
And then the drums. Yeah, we kept doing. We couldn't stop doing LaGrange in cluster.
Start over, Lou.
We're doing this on our iPhones.
Wow, Dan's old Zal. With his crazy hair.
You know, his dad died 20 years ago.
That's he used to drink a lot of booze, that man did.
Had a lot of rum and cokes. And then you have to wait
for Lou's off for the timing. After we do the, he got a lot of my hang out there. That's when, oh.
I'm telling you. I say we just cut it to the. Play the actual song, Lou. Do you have the actual song? Because it's such, I mean, there they are. ZZ Top, the motherfucking, dude, my stepdad, Nick, fucking loved ZZ Top.
He built cars, didn't he?
Fuck yeah. And he watched NASCAR in like 92.
Ooh.
No one was watching. Jacob, I forgot you're a NASCAR fan. There it is.
In Texas town.
At the south side of the range.
Right.
You know what I'm talking about. Just let me know
if you want to go.
shoes at home out on the ring. Take a look at the girls out there.
So I think we can cut that down to make it an easier thing just to jump into.
Oh, I could go any length because I have a guitar. Yeah, you could go as short as I want or as long as you want. Just cue me.
Rob Thomas is a dick, but he had a lot of hits.
But he's got a couple of good songs out there.
Yeah, anytime after that, go right to drums.
Just kicking it earlier.
Yeah, that's the better version.
I wanna go.
We'll annoy the shit out of somebody with that.
Oh, I don't think it'll stop. We're gonna take our first break. No, I don't want to. I thought that was actually the song.
Dan, that's a little early for a break. But maybe you want to go pee with Rob Thomas.
You they, got a lot,
they got a lot of celebrities peeing in that bathroom right there.
Is ZZ Top still... They're still touring, right?
Yes. They're so good.
We should go fucking see that. Have you seen them live?
Yeah.
Are they great live?
I saw them at Sturgis Bike Week.
That's a great place to see ZZ Top.
Up in, South Dakota. It was awesome.
There must have been a lot of leather.
Them and Kid Rock, same night.
A lot of leathery skin in that audience.
A lot of leathery skin. They said it was like very going to be very debaucherous at Sturgis, but I didn't find it to be.
I found it to be very quite polite.
I really did. I thought it was going to be like, I didn't see, I barely saw tits.
No, they're overseas.
Barely saw puss. It doesn't matter, guys, because our concert docket is...
They're playing in Pueblo, Colorado? Wow. Oh, the Colorado State Fair. All right, good for you.
Gone to Pueblo.
Here it comes. Here it comes. New York's coming. Poor Chester.
Billy, that's not going to work on the song. What are you doing? Are you stroking out, Billy?
I'm having a stroll. I'm smelling burning. My systolic's higher than my diastolic. That's a bad number right there.
As they get older, they start doing medical advice.
Take a baby aspirin.
Get some sleep.
Thin out your blood.
And make sure you go to bed at a reasonable hour.
You want to get a good 8 hours in every night. It works for me every time. Yeah, they're not coming anywhere near here.
They've had beards for over 30 years.
And the fun fact, the drummer's name? Anybody?
ZZ.
The drummer who doesn't have a beard, his name is?
Frank Beard.
Frank Beard.
Oh, Jacob nailed it.
Yes, it's such a fun fact about ZZ Top.
Frank Beard. And you know what? I think we all learned something here today on the bonfire.
What?
The drummer of ZZ Top's Frank Beard, and that you want to heart punch Rob Thomas.
I don't want to, but I want him to come in here.
They're so badass.
I have questions for him. I know, but you know, it's funny, they're old men, so they dress them up to look really cool, but like, yeah. It's funny if you got like, if you hung with how, what old men they just are.
Yeah.
It would bum you out.
Like after, you mean after the show where they're like, hey, can you pass me that Pellegrino? You're like,
I mean, just like inside those leather pants that Dusty's wearing over there is just, no, that's actually Billy Gibbons. Inside those leather pants is just like the most frail little vulnerable old man legs.
Well, it's like Lemmy looked like you could push him over.
Yeah.
You could have.
Yeah. He's like, I gotta take calcium pills because my bones are weak. I might have hollowed bones. Yeah, you know, it's called soft.
Here, I got one ready.
I take those Sally Field pills and I get my yoga from Jamie Lee Curtis. It's really good.
I'll take a a prune smoothie. I like a prune smoothie. A nice Centurum. And then I have a walk with my wife. You know, we see a lot of things on the path. Old ZZ Top might be here. My wife.
Once you get into the rhythm of it.
My wife, Deborah, tells some good stories. Yeah, but she repeats a lot. About old married problems.
I have to live in Florida 6 months a year, 'cause the humidity is good for my bones. They get a little bit of rickety at night. Oh yeah, have mercy.
I moved on down to Tucson to retire. You know, my grandkids never visit. They say they're always busy.
Retired ZZ Top is the best. Well, I got a couple friends. We meet for lunch or perhaps a 5 p.m. dinner. They got a lot of good deals at that hour.
I play my game of bridge. Patrick always wins. His son was killed by a drunk driver. Yeah, that was 17 years ago.
Well, I've got adult onset diabetes, but every now and then I treat myself to a caramel. It really hits the spot. Oh, yeah. Oh.
Playing shuffleboard out back. Movie night's tomorrow, but that Jamaican nurse keeps stealing my pills. I think he took some of my jewelry. I'm so happy we found this.
Well, they say I got Alzheimer's. At least this guy who keeps telling me he's my son does. I don't know who the hell he is.
I used to live by myself. I'd mow the lawn. Then they put me in this retirement home. Yeah, I can't find my war medals.
Well, I don't like living in this home, but Beverly's grandson comes on weekends and plays the piano. He's not that bad for a 13-year-old boy.
Wow. The snacks are good. Dinner's fine. I didn't realize that this was a Jewish retirement community. I believe in Jesus. All right, let's take our first break. It's The Bonfire on Comedy Central Radio. We'll be right back.
And now, back to The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Yeah, Steve Winwood, Freedom Overspill. We're doing music that my dad would have listened to since it's his birthday, or would have been his birthday. 68.
It's still his birthday.
It's still his birthday, but he would have been 68. It's The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95, also known as the Sons of Gary. That's what they call us on the streets. So it's a Gary birthday, so you got to do Gary music. Groundhog Day, we got to rock.
We got to figure something out.
Gary music for you. I'm Dan Soder, that's Big J. Oakerson. Joining us in studio, friend, comedian,
foe.
Confidant. Sometimes nemesis. Hilarious comedian Mateo Lane.
Oh, there's a crowd.
Yeah.
Amazing.
We only do our shows in stadiums.
Wow,
dude.
That's great.
So we're, before you came on the show, we were talking about Rob Thomas was in the studio, was in the building.
From Matchbox 20?
Oh, yeah.
Is there still a Matchbox 20?
There is a, is there still
no, now he seems to be fronting Chicago.
Yeah.
Like the old band from the 70s?
Whoa. All Let's right, pump Mateo. The brakes, Mateo. You're young.
Is that what has it?
First of all, they were also around in the 80s.
Yes, they were very popular.
They've never stopped touring.
They're like Linda. Didn't they sing with Linda Ronstadt a lot?
No. What?
I feel like no, that was the Eagles. That was the Eagles.
Okay, don't you ever call Chicago the Eagles, Mateo.
I don't know. Guys, I'm...
You go, I'll come over there. I swear. I will. Mateo.
I don't know. I have to...
Do you know ZZ Top?
Yes.
Okay, do you know the song LaGrange?
I mean, I've heard it.
You know this lick.
This lick?
Mateo.
Yeah, I know this.
If you don't know,
you're gonna
Chicago,
go.
You're gonna have to go. They got a lot of other shows in this building. Oh!
We've been doing that for 15 minutes.
I mean, I listen to Mariah Carey. I have no business talking about ZZ Top.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with Mariah Carey.
Well, there's a lot
wrong. Now
there's,
there is.
There's plenty wrong with Mariah Carey.
She's all fucked up now, huh?
Is it just the wealth and the being insulated?
Well, her voice now sounds like beef jerky, so I think that has a lot to do with it. And she's taking a lot of pills, and she wears quinceañera dresses. It's not good.
She's taking a dive.
I think it's like trying to wrap your brain around, like,
not being an athlete anymore.
Aging.
Yeah.
You know, it's like...
She can't do all the acrobats and the high... But she doesn't help... I mean, Patti LaBelle can still sing, but she shouldn't help herself by the drinking.
Yeah, so she's like... So she is like an old weathered...
Oh, yes.
Is she? I mean, she always looks pretty good. I mean, she looks
She's kept it. She's
like a big titted, fat-assed, like, big older chick.
Yeah.
But she looks good.
She just, when she talks, she's real, like she's in under a haze, just tired, sleepy.
She's like, they gave me drugged like a circus chimp.
Mm-hmm.
But she had that meltdown.
That way I don't rip anyone's face off.
Didn't she have that Times Square meltdown?
Yeah.
She just quit in the middle of the song.
Yeah.
Like, fuck.
Actually, I was on her side for that because it seems like they fucked up the equipment and then she was like getting frustrated.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, girl, you've been in the industry now for how long?
14 years, honey. Oh, no. Oh, God damn it. I read that cue wrong.
Oh, there's a picture of Mariah.
Yes.
I saw her Christmas concert, which was half lip synced and, the red dress. She looks like a centaur. But, she came out in that outfit and there was a literal audible gasp from the audience. Like,
yeah, she looks like a 1920s trapeze artist.
Yeah, it looks well. No, because she can't lift herself up off the ground.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Trapeze artist who's lost it. She goes, I can't go in the sky.
And I've seen her live 7 times and felt nothing every time.
Really? And she's one of your favorite?
It's a love hate. There was a group of gays next to us who were doing coke at her Christmas concert.
That's great.
Coke. That's the place.
God, gay guys really do know how to party all the time.
I mean, and first of all, at a Mariah Carey concert alone, that's weird to do coke.
All right, guys, I just want to get out
there. That's Mateo, not Mariah, by the way.
I just want to get out there before she hits.
He goes, listen here, honey.
I don't want to do Vision of Love before I'm out there. So
I swear to God, if she does Heartbreaker and I'm not a half eight ball in, I'm going to scratch someone's goddamn face off.
But I mean,
I'm going to suck off the horn player, see if I can get us backstage.
But it's a Christmas concert, so this would make more sense than her being like, Christmas time. You know, I mean, it's like, what?
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, she's doing fucking All I Want for Christmas, and they're like, hold on, let me do a key bump. I feel it more.
And I brought Evan Williams with me, who's like a recovering coke addict, so I thought it'd be hysterical if he relapsed at a Mariah Carey Christmas concert.
Where was it at?
It was at the Beacon Theater.
Oh, beautiful.
Well, the theater was.
Yeah.
The show, not so much.
It was real
Nick
tough.
Nick Cannon, huh? Nick Cannon jumped in there too late in the game.
No, he got her at the right time and then ruined her. When he met her, she was super hot.
Do you blame him for her...
I blame Mariah.
You blame Mariah?
I think she's cuckoo bananas.
Yeah, you've been famous since you were 19. You can sing like an angel.
Stern used to play those audio clips. Yeah, like her talking. Yeah, her little lambs. She would like talk to her audience.
That's when she was losing it. She would leave messages on her website. And like went right before she had that meltdown. She was drunk. And she was just like, everyone, I'm tired. Just maybe I won't. Like, it sounded very suicidal.
I swear to you, gay icons always go to become some pilled up booze bag.
Well, it's just
it's like Liza Minnelli.
But I just want to say, I've recovered, and I really feel a lot better.
Yeah, but they really do. It's the party lifestyle, and they just...
The first thing my mother said to me was, Liza, call an ambulance. But really funny.
Do you think that is Liza Minnelli, like... Is that the same thing that hampered Mariah Carey, where it's so much fame, so much money, that you're just fucking destroyed?
It's just these gay men are just enabling these women to mental disorders.
They're like, go crazy!
Judy, Liza. I mean, you know, Barbara has not gone off the deep end, but she's also secluded herself from the world forever.
I would say she lives in an ivory tower.
Yeah.
I mean, like, literally.
Yeah. Like, she's like, my chickens lay green eggs. And it's, all right, Barbara.
But she really is one of those people who's like just away from the world.
Yeah. And yeah, she's alive because of it. I mean, Mariah, I give her 15 years max.
Yeah.
Mariah, right. So it's 2017, so you say by 2032 she's out.
Yeah, for sure.
All right.
I mean, Whitney Houston had a real long run.
Whitney Houston was like, kept battling back, like she was down 3-1 and then even the series, and you're like, she might be all right, and then you're like, oh, she gets
it. Yeah, then the last 3 years of her life, you're like, yeah, it's about time.
Yeah.
That's cool. She did the best thing for her career. She died.
Courtney Love does all that, though, too. Sometimes she pops up, and you're like, oh. She gets, she pulled together, and then
she's looking
like,
a little.
They're always like a 9-7 Steelers team. You're like, well, are they not going to make the playoffs? And well, then they do, and you're like, I think they might win the fucking Super Bowl.
Madonna's the one that, like, I mean, she, her face looks like the V for Vendetta.
She looks like she was half bred with an alligator. Like where it was an island of Dr. Moreau, where they're like, my greatest creation, a pop star mixed with a swamp monster.
Yeah, she really has the same body as Lance Armstrong.
Yeah,
yes,
but like
Madonna and Lance Armstrong. The same build.
But if Lance Armstrong only lived in Florida.
Oh, and I watched some of that Rebel Heart tour Madonna thing on Showtime. I mean, her like fake playing the guitar at one point.
Oh,
was so,
please.
Like, oh,
can
yeah.
You find,
that's worth it.
Can you also find Celine Dion air guitaring?
It's the greatest
yes,
thing in the world.
Yes, Dan, I love that.
Not
you
air,
know that.
When she fucking on VH1 Divas, I've watched
the
it a million
live.
Times.
Oh, yeah.
It's not that. It's the grossness of her in a pantsuit is when the other girl sings and she looks like she's like just pumping her, like dick pumping. You're like, ew. Someone get Nana off the stage. She's dick pumping.
She was a fast machine.
If you look at the live,
man, look at me pumping my pelvis. Yes,
this is my pussy. Look at my fresh pussy.
And if you watch Celine Dion,
we'll put this out at the Bonfire SXM.
Go to the beginning again. I'm angry.
No, that's not the part. That's the best part. I'm telling you.
She was never even a little bit of rock and roll. And I'm, by the way, she's singing this in Anastasia, and I'm glad Anastasia's forgotten about. Oh, God.
It's all these moms losing their shit.
He was a fast machine. He kept his motor clean.
It's just so clean.
Yeah.
The part where she pumps her hips is my favorite thing in the world.
I feel like screaming faggot at this moment.
Oh. Here she goes.
Oh my God.
She's probably working back at a Target.
Is that Bono?
Yeah.
Also, I love the early like aughts and their fashion.
Yeah, she looks like a casino worker.
It looks like.
Yeah, she
she's in
is.
Between shifts.
She's a blackjack dealer now?
Oh, and it's the second verse. It's the second verse when she does
Celine
it.
Celine is just so... You know what it is? It's, she's just that weird foreign...
Yeah, it you're right. It's the foreign feel of American rock. You can't adapt it.
Watch here, dude.
Right here.
The audience hates this.
How are you doing, Casino?
No, you fast forward too far, Christine.
But Celine's voice is great.
Back up.
Yeah, I mean, Celine's...
Back up. Here we go.
This is really good for the listeners at home.
Oh, yeah, it's all visual.
Oh.
Everyone imagine...
So you just saw your mom blowing a guy.
Right there. Oh.
Imagine Gumby in a cancer wig, like pelvis.
Yeah. Where he's like...
Oh, look at me now. I flex my hips. Oh, do you know who loved that? That's the top row. Like,
pow, pow, pow.
I took that. That man was a fast machine. I took him like this. Pow, pow. Even though I've only had sex with a 7-year-old man.
Rene, you keep my motor clean.
Some people say I can eat an apple through a fence.
Yeah.
What I eat, it's like a snake. You can see what it is in my belly.
I mean, they might spook her.
Yeah.
Hey, AC/DC was not thrilled.
This is what AC/DC had in mind when they...
Huh? Were they mad about that?
They were not into it, certainly.
Wouldn't you be mad about it? I'm mad about it now. I don't even care about AC/DC.
No, but I love that.
I don't care about AC/DC either. But
I like AC/DC.
That's appalling.
That is pretty douche.
That was really embarrassing to watch.
Guys, yeah.
I'm thinking for the set, maybe I do an SEDC. And they go,
Celine, why don't we go with the old classic ballad?
Yeah, and they go,
I would like, if it's okay with you to do this AC/DC song, you shook me all night long.
I don't know what the fuck they could have paid this thing to have, like, this weird assortment, like Anastasia, like, who is
it? She was super popular in Europe, like, when I was, like, 15, 16, because I remember being in Italy and my cousins were like, Anastasia's the best. And I was like, no, she's not.
Who is Anastasia? Madonna.
Oh, this is when Madonna falls. I love when Madonna gets the cape ripped off her and she just falls to the ground. Bye, girl.
At the Bonfire SXM. I mean, that's a solid 4 steps down.
Well, my thing is that the real skill in this is that the sound guy had to turn her lip syncing part off.
Oh. Wait, yeah, play with the full volume, Lou. Like, I want to hear
it. Let down my yoke.
And why are there just gay men and horns?
I let down my pipe.
The most scared person is Lourdes, because you know Lourdes is going to get it when she gets home.
Yeah, but you know Madonna didn't. She made that old man falling down noise. And she goes, oh, boy, there we go. She goes, watch out. Here we go.
Because I'm crazy.
Here it comes. Oh, shit. Now. It's turned on her mic.
She's doing the falling down.
Oh, get into the groove for... What? Hang on. Wait. Hang on. Got it. Hang on. What? No. I'm going.
Hold on. She goes like this. It's attached.
There's a dog.
Somebody could do me a favor and just... Because one little clip's not coming. Okay. All right. Don't pull, Zach. Hey.
You see her play it again? Play it from the top? She goes like this. She goes,
It's clipped on.
Desmond, it's clipped. Done. Got you.
Describe that one sentence.
It's clipped.
Ah, fuck. I thought this was Velcro.
Yep.
When she gets up, she goes, it's all right, I'm okay. Okay, she was
on the ground in a huddle, and she goes, oh, you faggots are fired. Because I'm crazy for you.
She goes, I'm going to lay more waste than the bathhouses in the 80s, because you're all done. You're done. Do you understand? You're done. I'm going to run
through you guys like AIDS.
Yeah, she goes, I am fucking Madonna. You are all done. All right, get back up. Get my cape.
And Madonna's now in her early hundreds, so that fall could have killed her.
Dude, what if that would have sidelined the tour because of a busted hip?
Oh, yeah. I mean, listen, she's a Methuselah up there trying to, like, sing and dance still and be sexy. And it just, Ariana Grande falls on stage. You know Mariah watches that on loop.
Oh, here it is.
Bye, girl, bye.
That wasn't bad. Good
save. That wasn't that bad.
Big deal. Most of the place just went, ooh, ass flash.
Yeah, whoa.
Her voice is so, like, she has, like, the diction of a fog machine.
Why? She just goes,
You can't understand a word she says.
Play some Ariana Grande.
Iggy Azalea. Not a single word.
Iggy Azalea.
She's bottom heavy. I'm surprised that low center of gravity.
Iggy Azalea has so much implants in her butt, it doesn't matter if she falls.
Is it really? So she's just, that's just basically like
she
one of those bumper.
She looks like an asshole.
That's like one of those bumper protectors?
I don't know.
Whoa! She fucking fell. Oh my God. She goes backwards off the stage.
Her ass literally dragged her up.
She went down though like she was going into like a fun party.
Dude, Ariana Grande's got fucking 2 falls.
Yeah, she's a real clumsy ass.
Why is Ariana Grande trying to be Mariah Carey?
Oh, you said it.
Well,
you can say it.
I don't know. What is?
You said play some Ariana Grande.
She's at Fiat right now because she's Italian.
Not just the video.
Oh, what's her mute? Is this
her hear it. Oh, it's a concept piece.
It's just
nondescript music.
It's just all slurred together like she's hammered.
The only one who has worse diction than her is Janet Jackson, who just whispers through every song. Literally, am I wrong? And she also laughs at herself. Every Janet Jackson song.
Black Lou's agreeing with him on this one.
Every Janet Jackson song is this.
261 million.
You're always doing that. What the fuck are you talking to, Janet?
But I mean,
I'm killing with this guy.
Ariana Grande had 261 million views. I mean,
I know.
What, we're bringing up Rhythm Nation, like, didn't jerk off of this. Even Mateo did to the Rhythm dance Nation. Steps.
Well, because she looked like she looked like a man.
Yeah, I didn't
in this video.
No, I didn't jerk off to Rhythm Nation.
What was the one with the silk size?
That's the way love goes.
No, what's the if? If was the one I jerked off to. I'm sorry.
Janet Jackson can get it.
Oh, yeah.
She's hot.
I'm sorry that I'm just a union guy and I like jerking off the
Rhythm Nation. Remember the pictures came out of her with her bald box, suntanning?
Yeah.
But she looked a little older by that point.
Oh, this was the video I jerked off to.
If by Janet Jackson. I miss the 90s.
Yeah, we're allowed to be a little more sexual.
I don't know if it's an age thing or what. I never know, but all that Ariana Grande, not that they don't have some songs that are just going to be catchy by nature, but I feel like these songs are like, they're so...
Well, it sounds
I think a song now is supposed to be nondescript. It doesn't have like verse hook or verse chorus,
and
verse
it
chorus hook.
Sounds like Siri singing it.
Yeah.
Everything
is
so auto-tuned.
I mean, yeah.
This is Janet. Now, Janet really loved a big warehouse with lighting and...
But like, I like this album. I like this album though very much. The one where the guy's holding her titties, right?
Oh man.
Yeah, but Big J, you also love Barbara Streisand's Memory, which warms my heart.
It's true. It's very true.
Yeah, she does a dance where she dances in front of a dude and puts her head by his crotch.
You know
and
what?
The way she's dressed in the bamboo black. Oh man, Vanilla Dance.
Vanilla Dance coming out.
I also miss epic entrances. Like this entrance is so gay and epic. I mean, where I want this.
Yeah.
Where's
and
this?
Look at the choreography. Oh, she's so hot. Get out of this. Move it. Yeah, there you go.
I mean, okay, now try and figure out what she's saying.
I've known this song for 20 years. I have no idea.
Of course. Of course not.
And what you guys don't realize is she's just giving directions to program a VCR.
And then you're in hit mode and then you're playing. Change inputs to TV video.
And she will laugh at herself at some point in this song.
Yeah. She goes,
when you record with the tape, you make sure you have set it.
If somebody took the tab off. Put a piece of tape over the tab.
Now make sure you don't record over my birthday.
So hot in this video.
Yeah, no. She's
good. Right there. Oh, boy. Oh, man. If I didn't jerk off to that one time, I did it a million.
And all that guy went home was like, her pussy stank.
He went,
long day of dancing.
He went, he goes, okay, first off, Janet, don't grab my head like that. We are peers. And in my mind, a 13-year-old, I was like, that guy's probably going to kiss her pussy.
Oh, none of us knew the dancers were gay when we were kids. They can get it to
work. Those guys are jacked. Yeah. That's all I thought.
I was like,
their bodies move so well.
These guys should be the WWF.
If these were girls, I'd kiss them. What do you think that means?
Let's talk about the bees and the bees.
Everyone's got a stinger in this world.
That's what I'm saying. It was great. I loved this video.
Oh, Janet, what a good time that was.
Yeah, I mean,
she really. But it's funny how much she peaked and looks like in her. This is all her 30s,
mm-hmm.
like mid 30s, mm-hmm. I think.
Oh,
well,
right
she
there.
Was smart. She just got a nose job. She didn't look like a Korean woman like her brother.
Yeah,
but it's like really some of these people like can hold it together really nice too, and then once like those
early
40s hit, then it just goes fucking wacky.
I call them the Jermaine Dupri years. When you get
how old's Lady Gaga?
Oh, 72. She's posing as a 31-year-old, but let's call a spade a spade.
Which is 31, she says?
Yeah. I like Lady Gaga. Why did I say that? Like that was shocking. But what I'm trying to say is like I think she's great.
So her singing's good, stage performance
great
is good.
Great singer. She's a really good piano player, and she writes and composes her own music.
That's
and
awesome.
She did wacky shit, and she spoke to gay people. I mean, she
did it right.
She got it. But, you know, and also the one thing too is like she was actually speaking about the gays. Like all these pop stars before her, like every blue moon a pop star would be like, I do appreciate my gay fans. You know, so it was nice to get Lady Gaga to be screaming about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, she was very big.
Yeah.
Little monsters.
Speaking of pop stars from the 90s,
yeah, this is going to be great.
Because she can play her ass off. Let him hit me, raise
it, baby, stay with no, she could play her ass off.
Yeah, like she did that album with Tony Bennett.
Love.
And, you know, there's
no
like...
No one listened to that.
Well, I did. I'm a Tony
with her and Tony Bennett. I don't know. I love Tony Bennett. I mean, I don't know what they're doing to keep him alive.
Dude, it's crazy. I was at Bumbershoot in Seattle in 2012, and I got a little too drunk, and he was there, and I was
I'm going to Bennett?
I'm like, I'm going to go see some Tony Bennett. And I was so high and drunk that I sat there for a little bit, and I was like, this is sad.
Because
he was like...
Can we play some piano, or someone play a piano? I have a good Tony Bennett impression.
Oh, nice.
Just play any piano.
Any piano, and I can just... Because Tony, any jazzy song. But I'll show you how he sings now. Because he used to be like a real belter.
Yeah.
You know, like, so... You know, but now he does the, like, sort of sing.
The talk.
This is a little song I'm going to sing. So...
That's, I mean, almost dead accurate.
I mean, the vibrato.
Yeah.
Never going to be today. You know, same thing as Liza Minnelli. And
so they all, once, I mean, singing is one of those things.
Gripping on, it's fucking... Verbally fighting through COPD.
Patti LaBelle's the only one who can still sing.
I don't know. Yeah. Hey, everybody having fun up there? Tell us.
Guys.
Hey. Hey, all right.
They
this
sound
is an
oldie like...
but goodie. That's why the lady is a tramp.
That's what
hey, is my bow tie too tight?
Hey, guys. Is it just me or are the lights going on and off? I left my heart in San Francisco.
That's what Lindsay Lohan sounds like right now.
Let's all go to the movies. Yeah. Hey, does anybody else taste nickels?
Yeah.
Anybody tasting nickels?
Hey, why do I see
the room spinning? I have a headache behind my eye.
Why do I see my brother who died in 1982?
Does anybody see these shadow people coming off the wall?
Is this the end of Ghost, or am I wrapping up a concert?
Hey, that's why the doobity-doo. Hey, anybody see those shadow people coming off the wall?
Is this the sound check or the fifth show of the tour?
Does anyone else feel wet?
He goes, one more. Everybody, give it up. Give it up one more time for ZZ Top. They were very good on you.
They were good on you. Let's take a break, and then we'll come back. I want to show you.
Dude,
I wanted Mateo to be here for the...
I can't wait to watch
it. Oh, what is...
Lou sent me a video earlier that we just have to...
I haven't even watched it yet. I'm going to wait to watch it with you.
Okay.
And,
very funny.
And we'll be right back. We're hanging out with Mateo Lane. Mateo is going to be headlining... Caroline's Christine.
Go check out Mateo Lane. Very
tomorrow.
Funny. He's at Caroline's on Broadway.
Tomorrow night. Thursday, June 15th, 9:30 p.m. Get your tickets at carolines.com. Mateo is absolutely fucking hilarious. Very talented. Make sure you check that out. And then we'll be right back with him. It's the Bonfire.
That right there is some B-side Harry Chapin. WLD, it's a Gary Music Day. My last big gig.
You guys ever rock out to Mary Chapin Carpenter?
Ooh. Was she even related? Was she related to Harry Chapin?
I don't know, but I love her.
Yeah, Mary Chapin Carpenter's great.
She is great. I love that you know her.
That's Mateo Lane sitting in with us. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson. Mateo Lane's going to be at Caroline's on Broadway tomorrow night. That's Thursday, June 15th at 9:30. So go to carolines.com and make sure you buy tickets if you're in the tri-state area. He's fucking hilarious. If you're in New York, definitely check him out at Caroline's tomorrow night at 9:30. And you can check out Big J this Friday in Poughkeepsie at Laugh It Up. He's going to be there with Zach Amico and Justin Silver. That's Friday, June 16th, and then Saturday, June 17th, he's going to be at the Cherokee Casino in West Siloam Springs in Oklahoma. Go to BigJComedy.com for tickets now. Do it.
Do it. And Dan, of course, is going to be at the Denver Comedy Works coming home Thursday, June 29th through Saturday, July 1st. Get all your tickets at DanSoder.com.
Are you going to be in the Comedy Condo?
No, yeah. I stay at my mom's.
Damn, because I did a great painting.
I'm
going to
go check it out.
You did a great painting.
I did a great painting. I'll let you see Tim Dillon
staying there. So I'm gonna I'll go hang out there.
It's an awesome condo.
Yeah, I gave him
the
condo.
He's getting it to himself?
Yeah.
It's a good one by yourself.
That's great.
We had Fenoya there, which was fine, but like it's weirdly none of the walls are attached.
No, nope.
Like okay. Up. So like in the master bedroom, like you could hear everything possible.
Oh, really?
Impossible to like fuck.
Well, I'm gonna go like hang out there, probably like in between shows.
And fuck.
Tim and I are just gonna get to it. He's been opening for me a while.
Oh, Tim is gonna destroy that place with young butts.
Oh yeah, he's gonna get a Grindr in Denver.
No, actually, Grindr in Denver is pretty. It's pretty sad.
Is it really?
Yeah, for the whole week I was on Denver, and I swear to you, I was like, really, I'm not gonna hook up once with anybody.
It was bad.
At least the downtown area where I was, because it only shows you by the foot.
Straight mountain men.
Yeah.
They're just like, I'd like to eat some fucking trail mix and have sex with a woman with wide hips.
Yeah, you drew a Maleficent, right?
I did.
Fucking amazing.
I'm excited to see it.
I was very
what
proud of it.
What painting did you do?
Emily Heller took all the white, so I couldn't do anything else. You couldn't paint
Emily Heller
did
like a self.
There it is. What? Oh, yeah.
Well, that's right. Christine took a picture of it.
That's fucking.
Yeah, we were texting about it.
Awesome. At the Bonfire SXM.
Look
on
at
Twitter,
the shading.
On Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat if you want to see Mateo Lane's Maleficent. How do you say it?
Maleficent.
Maleficent. Maleficent. Maleficent.
Maleficent.
Hi, you're being really maleficent right now.
Hi.
I just want to love you.
This is my lesbian voice. My name is Alexis, and my wife and I make our own water.
This is my lesbian voice.
Hi.
Hey, I'm Aaron.
Hey, Aaron.
I'm Daniel Soder.
Hey, okay. I'm Daniel Soder. I played catcher in college.
Do you still play?
Oh, you know, in a city league on weekends.
Can you describe to the audience what you're wearing?
Right now I'm wearing some Levi's. They're pretty thick. They're pretty tight around my thighs. I got a Bonnie Raitt t-shirt on.
Hey, Dykos, we got to jam out. We have a 7:30 res over at Joe's Crab Shack.
Oh,
Chris!
Oh, so exciting. Oh, thank you.
Chris!
Now, should I wear my dickie or just wear my house coat?
I'm so excited that I watched maybe a minute of this video, but yeah. I know we are all going to come at this.
Lou, explain how you found this video.
Please, Lou.
That we're about to watch.
I just came across it, and it's,
You came across
it. Yeah, what are you, a kid?
There's
are
no
you a
tea?
Kid who just found porn?
Well, now you don't get an explanation, dickheads.
I came across it.
I was over by the train tracks, and
it was after we had Pischetti dinner, and
Mom?
Then my mom said I can go to my room and play on the computer.
But Robert
said
I
play on the machine.
But Robert said that I could go out back until the sun went down, and I went by the tracks, and then I sawed it.
I sawed it.
I sawed it.
Go ahead.
Nope, now you get nothing.
No.
Oh, come on, Lou.
Your jersey came out. You came across it. Are you on Brad's team now? Are you Team Brad? You shut down emotionally because
no,
we make
just,
fun of your said across?
Yeah, I'm going back in my shell.
Don't. How'd you come across?
I love Turtle Lou.
I don't really have a story behind it.
You just found it online and you knew we'd love it?
It was so ridiculous, I know you would love it.
But where did you see it online? You were
BuzzFeed.
Looking at, where would you have seen this pop up? BuzzFeed?
Yeah.
And it was on today?
Yeah.
Right. Send me a WorldStar link.
Oh, WorldStar.
All right,
WorldStar is at the forefront of all fucking internet videos.
Well, for me it is.
Yeah.
I was doing show prep, and I know that's your favorite.
Yeah,
so
it is.
That's where
I
did you watch the lady? Did you watch the lady getting arrested, yelling at her? The black lady getting arrested, yelling at her boyfriend. She's like, help me out, nigga. I'm your baby's mama. Because
right.
That's a headline of the video. Help me out, nigga. I'm your baby's mama. The cops just dragging her on the ground.
Cops are like, well,
hilarious.
At this point, I don't think he's going to jump in.
It's like a 17-second video. It's just that sentence.
He
it's
goes,
just her yelling.
I'm pretty sure Miss, he's not going to help you out here. Just let's just get back into the back of the car. Christine, do you have the video?
Mm-hmm.
Let's play this shit.
Oh, I can't wait. Does he sing rap?
Do you know what it is?
Oh,
so we should explain what it
like
is.
Like he Janet Jackson's it.
Oh, this sure. sounds fabulous.
We're, so Mateo, to explain to you a little history of the show,
mm-hmm.
we have, we find it very fascinating when either celebrities or children of celebrities try to become musicians. And they do it without actually being...
This is inside the actor's studio.
So, what we like to do is dissect it, understand it. Because when you have rich parents, you believe you can make music.
When you have rich parents, you do believe you can make music.
And
I am losing my mind.
So Tommy Hilfiger's son, Paris, right, was a rapper. What was his name?
Paris Hilfiger?
That sounds about
Tom,
right.
Tom Hanks' son, who thinks he's black.
Oh,
did,
Mateo.
Is
that
also.
Is our
Chet free. Hayes. I
that's,
mean, you're right. Now you're in the Bonfire's wheelhouse.
That's mm-hmm. our free bird. That episode of when I found out about Chet Hayes, I
Rob
went
Schneider's daughter has a huge hit out.
Okay,
really?
First off,
yeah.
Did not know that. I didn't know that fucking Deuce Bigelow's daughter was fucking dropping heat. It's a hit?
It's a huge hit.
In the United States?
I didn't know
yes.
your daughter.
Because I think she tries her hardest not to associate with
it. It's called, give me a disc, give me like a techno beat. Give me a techno beat. I'm gonna do it. No, just, like, can you get interest instrumental?
Get my instrumentals up.
Here we go. Oh, damn. Dan Areno.
That's
the man.
What I was thinking.
Dan Tanos.
Ah, Dan.
Dan Shamalama Dan Dan.
Oh. You're like,
Dan,
your
making,
dad
copies. Making copies. Making copies. Making copies. Dan, making copies. Dan and the man.
Making copies.
Dan Areno.
Making copies.
Dan Alicious.
Making
Dan. Dan Squares. Dan Cube.
This is the actual song. Her name's Elle King. And it's called America's Sweetheart.
Yeah, this
think your words will make me black and blue, black.
Does she have Schneider face?
We'll see.
If by Schneider face not attractive, yes.
Well, really?
Isn't that Rob Schneider as the lion from The Wizard of Oz?
She looks like she's 40. She looks like she's Rob Schneider's sister.
Yeah, really.
The hair extensions make me the most upset.
I'm telling you.
She has a lot of room between her titties.
I don't want to be a pop star. I'm afraid. I'm afraid of what the crowd's going to think. Oh, God. Dad. The Manimal movie paid for this. Oh, they said I never had a voice. I got a voice.
She's not at all expected her to look like.
Yeah, no, I
met her once. I had to open for Rob Schneider one weekend, which was a horrific experience. He almost fired me on the spot and forced me to wear a suit and play clean, which I was like, all right, really? So I guess I just shouldn't talk because I'm so gay. And then she came backstage and she was very nice, but I'll never forget her saying, I'm just going to go to the yacht tomorrow.
Is Rob Schneider living that kind of life?
I think he's made a pretty penny from his movies. But I don't think there's a lot of income coming in now.
She's a little confident porker, huh?
I don't like the way she sings, like she
runs.
Now my dad's got movies and can afford some studio time. I've got the attitude of a diner waitress.
She's like, hey, can I get that soup? And she goes, honey, you can get that soup when these cheeseburgers get to table 26. Wow, is your dad Rob Schneider? I'm not going to tip you.
Rob Schneider was like, honey, if I buy you the studio time, will you stop fucking black guys at the house while I'm gone?
She goes, Dad, I can't.
You like who likes you.
Yeah. He's like, they smell so good.
Look how short her arms are. She's a disproportionately built woman.
She's a T-Rex in a weave.
Oh, that's great. I'm doing big. All right. Well,
she really can't blow her nose or anything. Her hands don't touch her face.
Oh, no. I do think she's probably pretty talented. But she shouldn't have worn this outfit.
Yeah, this, I mean, like, why would you do that to yourself?
She's like a pirate mixed with.
She looks like the
Susan
white
Boyle.
She looks like a real G.I. Joe, like someone clipped her legs into the fucking dick piece.
She also looks like she's successful to like a land developer, like a wife of a successful land developer.
Mark bought all this land when no one told him to.
I don't think successful is the right word. Yeah. Just a land developer.
She looked definitely, that's a single wide body.
She looks like if she farts in those pants, she's going to have to like push it down to come out of her ankle.
It looks like she farted in her pants and she's waiting for any moment to get it out.
Or like when you jump in the pool.
The pool, yes.
Like push it down.
You're like, no, that wasn't fart bones. That was my, for some reason, my bathing suit just became a fucking parasail.
She goes, every time I stand, it looks like I'm in a pool.
Is that a guitar? They just put strings on her gunt.
I'll be honest, I'm kind of into it. This is for you. My pussy song.
Do you think Rob Schneider wrote it?
Dan the man, Dan Areno.
This is a Kia song.
Yeah. It's a what song?
This is Kia.
I do it. Just do it.
This is that one. Yeah, that's the famous one. My neck, my back.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Pussy and my crack. I'm into this.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
I mean, if she's out there working the road, God bless her.
Yeah.
You got to go put in the time.
After we ripped her into shreds.
Yeah, but that's...
Oh, she had it coming.
But that's an appetizer because... Here's the deal. Number one, she's not riding off it. Oh, here's the real video. I loved this video.
Oh, Kaya.
Shake your body, don't stop. Is it Kaya?
It's Kaya.
Do
it. Do it
now. Lick it good.
After she was on this show, she competed in the America's Next Best Female Rapper.
That was a show?
VH1. Like next Best
good,
Female
good
Rapper.
Good job, VH1.
Yeah. Okay. Done.
But gays are the problem.
Is that, yeah.
I'm just saying after this, it's like, but we're the problem.
Yeah.
I don't think a lot of black girls want their butt cracks licked.
I disagree. Yeah. I feel like more straight people I'm talking to are getting their assholes licked.
She's I'm all about a good asshole licking. I'll take it, I'll give it. But I mean...
She goes, my neck, my back, my pussy, and that'll do.
Yeah, yeah.
And bring your ass up here, I ain't gonna kiss you.
But black guys, you know, that was always the thing about black guys, don't really eat pussy, but it depends. If you go...
That's
Lou,
the thing?
Lou, you're a black dude that went to a white school...
It's my favorite thing to do on the fucking planet.
Yeah. No, I believe that. Yeah. I'm saying, but
same stereotype of gay men.
But I almost think the joke is
so stupid.
So dumb. I think that joke is so told at this point, and I think a lot of plenty, maybe even a majority of black guys eat pussy, but there are still a faction you talk to. They're appalled by the notion.
Why?
There's a Dominican comedian that I was talking
it's
to.
I'm not
going to name him, but he was like, I don't eat pussy at all.
Yeah, I'll tell you why I think so.
I think there's only one Dominican comedian.
Well, yeah, but you know what I'm
yeah.
It's, in the black community, there's a lot of weight on machismo. And I think that's like you're being like a bitch, like you're going to, you know what I mean? Like it's,
somehow you're a faggot if you eat a pussy.
To some degree. That's why I learned that early when I was in the black comedy, when I was in the black comedy circuit, man. Like, you really even make a joke if you were like, oh, that guy's whatever, I'll suck his dick later and blah, blah, you know, as a joke. They just don't like the joke. They're like, whoa, they don't want to hear the words sometimes. It's weird. Like, and that was when I was doing like kind of like the hood, like black rooms. Is because, yeah, it's just like a lot of machismo there. It's like it's what's clinged on to more than anything.
Well, yeah, because
up there is like, you know, your rep, your status is like,
I'd love to send them to a drag show.
It'd be absolutely great.
It'd be great.
I'll tell you what, we did it. We filmed with a bunch of thuggy black dudes for a Comedy Central webisode thing I did. And as the day goes on, the sillier things we made them do, they did kind of go in, like, we made them all run outside and buy ice cream and shit.
That most people, I mean, you know, not just being black, but anybody who puts on a type of persona, machismo, whatever it is, I think it's a little bit of a role play.
Yeah, you think they're,
do you
like,
know what I mean?
Do you think they're clinging to it to hide up insecurities?
Yeah, of course.
No, there absolutely is, but when you're living a role.
Yes.
Like, how long before it becomes...
reality.
Do you know what I mean? Reality.
Like, yeah, I always think about that with like super alpha guys who are like, bro, I'm just here to fucking smash pussy and crush jaws.
And be like,
and you're like, at one point in eighth grade, they had to be like, I'm gonna crush pussy. And they're like, I'm gonna
evolve from somewhere.
I'm gonna do it.
I'm gonna get pussy.
Yeah.
I wanna touch all the pussy.
Can I say something to you that I forgot to tell you? Speaking of celebrities' kids, I had a real genuine, this is gonna be funny because I'm making a joke, but a real cool moment I didn't tell them about yet, at the Comedy Store. Like, you know how influenced I am by Dice and how much
Yes, of course, absolutely.
When I was a kid and how, you know, me and my stepfather, all this corny shit I've said 1,000 times. Eleanor, who's Dice's ex, I still haven't met Dice and bullshit with him ever. She goes, I have some people out here that want to meet you. And she brings me outside, and it was to meet Max,
his son,
who I didn't know. I know who he is and of him. And he was like genuinely like a big fan of mine.
Oh,
that's
wow.
Awesome.
I genuinely was like saying like quoting stuff from my special.
That's
cool. And I was just kind of like, that's just a neat thing to kind of come around.
You haven't met Dice Clay yet?
No, not
what?
Really. No.
That's like, awesome though.
Passed by, but just the fact that his son, like it was kind of remind me of that Chappelle thing they keep saying. It's like, his kids aren't impressed that he's Dave Chappelle. They're impressed that he knows Kevin Hart.
Yeah.
So that was just kind of a neat thing that's like, at the time, being 12 years old and watching it with my stepfather.
Yeah.
His specials to his children now are like a fan of mine. I thought that was such a cool
thing. That's fucking awesome. That's great. And that happened last week in L.A.?
Yeah, I thought that was so cool.
That's
and
fucking
sweetheart
badass.
Of a kid, man. Really cool kid.
Will Smith punched
Mike. Wow, is that his son?
How much
right?
Is he? Yeah, they're both.
Oof, the one on the right can get it.
The one on the left looks like young Dice. I mean, that's what I meant.
Yeah, the
Max.
One on the left's cute too, and I'm not saying that, but the one on the right's like, hey, girl. Damn, he's got some good looking kids.
Good for Dice. Good job, Dice.
Hey. Dice!
Way to dump a load in the right there.
Your fucking jizz has good-looking kids in it, you fucking cunt.
Mary, Mary, quite contrary. Trim that pussy, it's so damn hairy.
Agoo! Now.
You ever hear when Howard and had Dice and Richard Simmons on all at the same time?
Oh, yeah.
It's great.
Yeah, that's one of my favorites. I say... It's 7:27.
Yeah, we're gonna have. Let's take our last
break.
Take
a break because we can just ride this one out until we come back.
And we have one more.
All right, this is our last break.
Last break, but then this is definitely gonna take a half hour.
It is, absolutely.
And we don't want to do that thing where we start and then stop.
And we're gonna have to use pause.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
We use pause a lot.
Oh, perfect.
We'll be right back. Mateo Lane, headlining tomorrow at Caroline's. Go to carolines.com for tickets. We'll be right back. It's the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Meets you at the border. Troy walked out of the Huey Lewis Jimmy Buffett concert. Yeah, that's Jimmy Buffett, son of a sailor, because it's Gary music on the Bonfire today.
J. Buff, rest in peace, Gary. Happy birthday.
Big ups, Gary. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson. In studio with us, Mateo Lane. We were talking Celine Dion. We were talking Janet Jackson jerk-off videos. Then we started talking about kids' music. Rob Schneider's 50-year-old waitress diner daughter.
Then we jumped into Black Guys Not Liking the Pussy. We have one call on the line. It is Saletta from Oakland who wants to ask what we're talking about Black Guys Not.
Saletta,
am I saying it right? Saletta?
Yes, I'm here.
Hi, Saletta.
Can you turn on your radio, though, too? Just because it will.
Oh, yeah, I'll turn it off.
All right, thanks.
Hi, Saletta.
Caught me just in time. Hey, how you guys doing?
Good. How you doing?
Hey, how are you? It's nice
I'm
to
good.
Meet you, Saletta. I'm not arguing that black, but I do believe many, many black men love deep pussy. I just know publicly a lot of black guys when I was growing up would just say they didn't.
Yeah, it was kind of like, I think in the early 90s, 80s and early 90s, black guys eating pussy were similar to white dudes being able to dance. And then all of a sudden in the 2000s, everything changed. And Everyone's like, Justin Timberlake came out. And black dudes started eating box.
And as a gay man, I don't care about any of this.
Justin Timberlake popped up. Black guys started popping down.
Okay, because I called you guys in the middle, and I know you guys. Sometimes y'all say some crazy. And please stop saying black room. What the hell is a black room?
No, that's what it's called in the comedy community.
Is like, that a term?
Yeah, that's a term in the comedy community.
Wait, what do you mean? Oh, like the black comedy room.
Yeah, but she means like when you work in a black room.
It's the same as like there's a gay room. There's a whole thing.
There's like
there's Hispanic rooms.
Corporates.
It sounds like a dungeon where there are only black people there. Like it's not inviting.
The club I started off at, God bless it. The club I started off at was like such a treat to start at because the Laugh House in Philly, the open mic night was 250 people sold out every single week. It was amazing.
And we're kind. And we're kind people. And we do, so we do eat, and that's why we're kind, because our men eat pussy.
Oh.
So I just want to let you know that that makes me happy.
Yeah,
so
I'm glad it does. Okay. I mean, that's why we do it.
Absolutely.
That's why we go down. Is to
I
make
love
you guys
how,
happy.
Like, that sounded so sweet and inspiring, but it
was about getting her box eaten.
Yeah, that was great.
She goes, and I just want to say, we all have blood, we all have bones, and we all love eating that pussy.
That one day, a black man and a white woman can stand atop a mountain, and he could eat that pussy. Oh,
he can nibble. He can nibble on that pink box.
Skies forever.
I'm gonna say, if you don't think black men eat pussy, ask white women.
Oh, shit.
That's actually great. She should be on this show.
That's their froyo.
Real talk.
You just made Black Lou pump fist the air. Like he just scored a hockey goal.
Well,
thank you, guys.
Of course. Thanks for calling.
Thanks for calling in, sweetie.
Bye.
All right. Now let's get to the
sweetheart.
Yeah. Our fans are the fucking best. Let's get to the issues at hand.
Oh, please.
We were talking about rich kids. We were talking about famous kids.
Now we've gone at Jaden Smith before.
We have talked about Jaden Smith.
Ridiculous.
We've gone at him before because
ridiculous.
His parents have been telling him he is a future king his entire life.
Or queen in some aspects.
Or in many aspects a queen.
Because he wears like dresses now.
But it's like that pursuit of happiness never stopped for him. Like they were like, you could do anything. Don't allow talent or rational thought or anything.
Well, Will Smith said he wanted to make sure he could teach his son that 2 + 2 doesn't need to equal 4.
Which is wrong. That is wrong. That's wrong, and you're dumb.
He is, I mean, this kid is
the embodiment of confidence.
He's just,
all confidence. He just thinks everything he nails, so he put up a song.
Extraordinarily, just out of the gates, unlikable.
He can't
Because who likes untalented, confident people?
Yeah, you're right.
They're the worst.
Yeah.
I wish I had a sliver of this kid's confidence.
Oh, my God.
A sliver.
First
if I did, I'd be a millionaire.
And you wouldn't be on the show. You would not be
on
our show.
Oh, I would 100% be on this show.
Okay.
If I ever make a music video, you please make fun of it.
Oh, 1,000%.
Thank you.
I will be there. We'll make fun of it while you're filming it.
Can we also be in it?
Yeah, also.
Yeah, of course.
I need to keep my SAG dues up. If you could just. So this has been watched 73,000 times, and the verdict's out that only
73,000 times?
And only 145 people.
Came out today.
That's not enough.
It just dropped. But let's watch his music video. It's Jaden Smith with the song Batman. Keep that fucking mouse close to the pause button.
Dude, this is...
First off, shot beautifully. The music video is shot gorgeous.
Well, his dad probably made him get major directors.
He's already a bad actor and all he did was get up. This is embarrassing. I'm embarrassed. Can we pause real quick?
Yeah.
Okay, I just want to explain something real quick.
Let me just explain what it is. He's out in the field and he's asleep. All of a sudden there's a noise. He sees what looks to be a bat signal and starts yelling fuck a bunch like he just choked a woman to death during sex.
And he looks like Tracy Chapman.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's sort of dressed like a...
Hey, I'm in a fast car.
He's dressed like a fat girl who works at Hot Topic.
Yeah. But or the girlfriend of a low-level hockey player.
Yeah, he's all like a lot of straps and...
And from the get-go, he starts overacting.
Yeah.
So we're all, I'm like, I've never been more embarrassed in my entire life.
It's 20 seconds, there's been no song, and you're already embarrassed.
Oh, I can't, I don't even know if I can
now you
handle
know why
the rest.
Now you know why we took our last break so early.
There's been the light twinklings of music happening.
Yeah, he's been
not talent, just music.
He's been fucking.
No, I'm saying in this song so far, there's been some light twinklings in the background.
Right. There's a bat signal.
Which looks like I drew it in with MS Paint.
He's got a glass.
Oh, he was drinking.
He's circling. And it's a flashback.
Okay, Mr. Wayne.
Oh, so he's supposed to be Batman.
No, he's going to be Batman?
The song's called Batman.
He's drinking.
Was that a French, una produzione, or was that Italian?
Yeah, you're bilingual, so you can read it. What does that say?
Presenta una produzione. Why is it in Italian?
Because he's fancy, Matteo. Batman speaks Italian. Yeah, I call
Presenta
it Italian.
Presenta una produzione.
I say it like my grandma. I call it Italian.
He's checking his phone.
Checking his phone.
This is a long build-up. How long is the song? The video is only 4 minutes.
There's rumors of a Batman circulating your name. What do you have to say to Gotham?
Who am I speaking?
This is an inquiry.
With whom am I speaking? People don't talk that way, especially him.
Why does he keep moving around that ice? What is he drinking?
He looks like Boy George.
Yeah.
It might be Boy George.
He also looks like he's doing math problems on a blank.
You think he's jumping out of the closet at some point, Jaden Smith?
I think he has already ran miles out of it.
Oh, really?
If we've gotten to this point, yes.
What's he writing?
Oh, God.
He wrote Batman on the mirror.
But real quick, his A's are just triangles. So I want everyone to know now that already shows that he's different. He's better than us because his A's are triangles. Now I will say this: his body can get it.
Bruce Wayne. Oh, he's Bruce Wayne, but he's like a modern Bruce Wayne.
The credits already. What?
Batman, 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 Joker just put me on acid. You wanna wait like a maverick, it makes him happy.
Pause real quick.
Batman, this Batman, is, Batman, you're a part. Fucking asshole.
I just wanna say.
What an asshole. What a complete and utter, Black Lou is upset. What, are you mad?
Yeah, he stole that. That's from Drake. That Jumpman, Jumpman, Jumpman. Y'all being up to something.
I don't like.
Okay,
I don't
but to be fair, Drake looks exactly like Liza Minnelli.
Yeah,
and also let's not forget he was in a wheelchair and his eyes are on the side of his head, and he's also half Jewish. I hate Drake.
The other half's amoeba.
Oh please, I hate him.
And I sound like a white stepdad where I go, I don't listen to Drake.
I'm unfamiliar with the songs.
Well, Mister,
what does he play?
Drake. What's his band's name? Go back. So he said. Christine, we're going to be doing a lot of going back.
The music video is half over with the song barely even started.
And so he's on top of it.
Yeah. Batman, Batman, Batman. Joker just put me on acid.
Who do you think he's saving?
Batman, Batman, fashion. Batman,
is this just like fashion. A really what the LA Geek Squad looks like?
I don't know, but this is so bad.
I love he just had the outfit. like that, this white Batman costume, he originally brought it out for Kanye and Kim's wedding like 2 years ago. So he just like did this based on the fact that he has a white Batman suit.
He went to Kanye and Kim's wedding in a white Batman
suit. That must have been thrilling.
He goes, guys, you,
somebody shows up, you're like, fuck, dude, fuck off.
Also,
like someone should yell at him like a kid that his parents never did. Be like, fuck off, dude.
Let me tell you who I am as a person. I'd be like this when I first see him. I go, oh, cool, he wore a Batman costume. And then when his cape unintentionally knocked my drink off the table, I'd be like, all right, you motherfucker, come on, dude. Watch your goddamn cape.
Hey, dude, your fucking, your arm spikes are getting in the goddamn...
Your arm shriekings are fucking everything up. I mean, he... All right, so now go back to the...
I just can't believe I get called faggot all the time, and this guy gets away scot-free, running around in a weird Batman outfit.
Can I tell you this right now?
I've been yelling at the screen all day.
But also, you have a real gripe. You have a real gripe about that. All right, let's go, because he should be... I mean, this is...
I learned nothing since last year. You got the renegade fabrics.
He's just dancing in the street.
He's bouncing in the streets, drinking that water again on a hill.
No, he was pissing.
Oh.
Go back. He was pissing on the hill.
It's weird. Why would you have your hair cover your line of vision?
That was really weird. He's just pissing on a hill.
Also, where do his dreads go when he puts on the Batman costume? You have to have short hair if you're wearing a Batman
suit. He unsnaps them.
Can we make our own version called Superman?
Superman.
With
Superman.
The same beat.
Watch, see?
Oh, he is pissing.
It's like a really dumb Halloween. Ain't got a mattress. Okay, hold on, real quick.
I mean, what's he talking
about?
Did
he get this from Hooked on Phonics?
It.
What's this?
That's not it. Oh, that was...
Did he lift from this then? But like, is that legal?
That's where he stole it from.
He stole it from Drake.
So basically all this cadence and how he's putting his words together is all from Drake.
So he's a rich kid that's just taking what he wants and doing with it what he
chooses. But does Drake know that he took it? Like,
Drake probably does not give a fuck.
I'm going to tweet him
like,
right now.
They're like,
tweet it.
They're like, stolen? What you mean?
He goes,
2 + 2 = 6.
He goes, last time I checked, the earth isn't round, nor is it flat. It's a hexagon. Because I choose it to be.
So you're saying stealing is defined as I took this? Because if you're going with that definition, then yes, I stole. But
you're limited.
That's not how I define it. My father told me I can define stealing however I want.
Because I also think that, my thought's not limited to know what crime and punishment is.
The problem is that he's a very good-looking young man, and it's embarrassing he's behaving this way. My Italian mother would never let me behave this way.
She's like, you are not a Batman.
There's something about somebody there to, like, you know, even out that spoon. You know, you gotta, like...
Yeah, you gotta have someone, you gotta take a couple ass whoopings.
Someone who's just telling you to shut the fuck up.
Do you need one person to tell you you can do anything, and you need one person to tell you you ain't shit?
Well, in my case, I had all of high school telling me, so, I mean, maybe he just needs to take my place and go back to high school.
He was homeschooled.
Were you very badly bullied in high school?
Oh, I mean, please, of course.
Yeah? Well, I don't know, you know what's very weird? I went to a predominantly black high school. And, it was very black. And I would say, like, the two of the most, maybe the most popular kids, but two people that seemed to not have much of a problem were Angelo and Andre, the two clearly gay guys.
Hey, sister friend!
Yeah, and Angelo was a white Italian kid, and Andre was black, and they both just seemed to, like, and by the way, like, didn't take shit, so if you were going to kind of bully them, they were, like, very flamboyant and big.
I wasn't out. There's also something about people who are out it's almost actually...
I don't know if they were both, I mean, they... Probably were.
I mean, his name's Angela.
I know, but no one really talked. It makes sense. Like, no one even asked, almost.
Yeah.
Just didn't kind of ask about it.
Well, you don't have to. Like, Angela, how was writing class? Ah, girl!
Yeah, basically, yeah.
So it was pretty well known that they were both gay. And
again, I was always the wrong. I was trying to follow everything, so I'd be like, Angelo's tucking his jeans into his socks. That looks pretty badass.
That's
and then
so
you come
cute.
To school the next day, and someone's like, don't Angelo your socks.
Yeah.
Let me just say this. This is how boring this song is, that we're talking about Angelo from your high school.
Yeah.
That's how boring
Angelo, blowing dudes in the gym locker.
Sucking off the teacher to get a good grade.
Angelo, Angelo, Angelo. Angelo. I mean, this is like all...
His sister's song is much better.
He is... Batman. Why you look fly out in hell? No. Don't get the album will sell. No.
But this shit might fly off the show. He's dancing? Bad.
This is like a really... This is like someone who's not creative trying to be creative.
This is what most of my art school experience looked like, actually.
Everyone's dressed like superheroes?
I think all those people there were just a bunch of disappointed fathers.
Yeah.
But Jaden has got a nice body. This is embarrassing. This is what I do on Saturday nights.
Hey, you want to get together with a superhero buddies and gay off?
Put on tight costumes and just wrestle?
I like how they try blurring out the McDonald's, but it's just a blurrier.
It's just a blurry McDonald's.
Why are all the superheroes' faces blurred?
Because they didn't sign releases.
Batman, and the man who is a spider.
A man who's better than good, you'd say he's super.
Yeah.
Batman.
Fantastic man. Fantastic man.
Ant-Man.
He's really good at stuff, because he's not from here.
Literally, the feeling I'm feeling right now is what I feel like my dad feels like when my brother and I were both like, we're gay. Shame, embarrassment. Actually, emptiness. I'm empty.
By the way,
on the inside.
He's walking away shamed, it seems, at the end of the video. But,
well, he should
and
be.
And he says Finn at the end, like it proved.
So it started in Italian and ended in French. They can't even get that right. Oh, it's not over. There's an extra special feature.
He is,
Is it a Celine Dion music video now?
I'm gonna bust just hit him.
Just some fucking coyote comes out of nowhere and just bites his ass.
Fire.
He's a pompous little dude.
Unlikable.
Does he have a statement out about the video?
Oh, but look.
Look up to see if he has tweets.
That was really embarrassing. I don't like feeling embarrassed for other people, and that's actually the worst. And I've seen people, you know, we watched Madonna tumble.
Yeah.
I always want to see more videos of him. Does he have anything?
You got to watch him being interviewed. It's out of control.
We've done that 1,000 times. But is he just not?
Can you have me back next time you have anything Jaden Smith related? Thank you.
Yeah, he'll be our Jaden Smith correspondent.
So wait. Zach in Canada says there's a good Jaden Smith song. Zach, you're opening yourself up for scrutiny here, buddy.
Zach, yeah, we'd like you to never call back.
We're going
to
make you stay in the Northwestern Territories.
Zach, you there? Can you put Zach on the horn? Zach, what's up, buddy?
Zach, we'd love your explanation.
Hey, so he actually has a song called Fast, where he's rapping, rolling around on the floor in a garage in a dress, but it's produced by Childish Gambino, and it's not half bad.
All right, here it is. Right,
that's always good when something's not half bad.
Not half bad, but I don't like
it's like when
like
you're at Applebee's and you're eating a bunch of things, you're like, I guess the apple blossom's not the worst. But it doesn't make it a good restaurant.
I still hate Applebee's.
Of course. Why you drive so fast? Girl, where you gotta go? Girl, where you gotta go? Baby, you should try and drive slow. I just wanna say gay men also say girl. I'm just trying to stay alive on the big screen. When you coming out to drive, all the kids scream. Zach, you promised this was half okay. I promise.
It's a minute 14 seconds.
It's really not bad for rap.
What the hell? Wow, this is horrible for rap.
This is, yeah.
And I know nothing of rap.
I mean, like, Kendrick Lamar is great.
I get what you're saying. I get what you're saying, Zach. It's like, at least, like formidable music.
Yeah.
Isn't this the same song we just listened to without the Batman costume?
He's just rolling around on a garage.
He also dresses like a real queef. He's dressed like a female tennis pro right now.
Billie Jean King.
He's dressed like Maria Sharapova.
And he's like,
he's wearing a skirt and a tight hoodie.
Like she's playing in
he
a cloudy.
Looks like he's wearing like grandma's house coat and leggings.
Yeah. He's trying to be. He's one of those people that's trying so hard to be different that it makes him look like a dickhead.
Yeah. Do you think Will Smith and Jada Pinkett are just like so self-involved
that they couldn't help but love it?
Yes. I think they were like.
They even said in an interview that they want their family to be like titans, like an empire together. I mean, they think they're doing it.
No, they are not, unless they are planning on failing so much that people forget their name and then surprising them with actually
something
decent. Yeah,
understand these kids are so young, dude. They still have a shot to just act in a movie that shoots them to the next level, and they can get put into those movies because of their family.
He has these unbelievably shot videos, and there's now one's called Scarface.
They have so much money.
So much money.
Oh,
they can
so
go
much
out.
Money.
Like, do they film this in Italy?
Play this, Lou.
How can a guy who I've never heard of has an album out have so many singles and videos?
I know.
And why do the videos take place in, like, these locations and shit?
Highly produced videos.
Highly produced.
Sorry, guys. I'm in New Zealand shooting my new video for a song.
Yeah, they're in Italy. Look, that sign's all in Italian.
He's wearing a mammoth hoodie. That's so gross.
My people must have been so confused.
Like, what?
We heard Will Smith, but this look like... Something bad.
Here's the thing about his videos. He's giving that, like, I've been so beaten up by life, I can't take it look. And you're like, no. You had a very nice life.
My robot butler broke down the other day.
My dad cut me off from his Fresh Prince of Bel Air royalty checks.
Now I only get the Muhammad Ali checks.
It really is the same thing as Tom Hanks, where Will Smith is so lovable, and he creates a piece
Will
of shit.
Will Smith is so hot. I would... Oh, my
but
God.
But Will Smith, it's like, I knew Will...
He's from over. He's from my neighborhood. I gotta love Will
Smith.
Will Smith's
husband is really hot, too.
Oh, boy. Claws are out.
She was so hot in Menace Society, and then I don't know what happened.
I love how he goes to Italy, goes to some hill town where literally they're known for, like, their truffle and, like, I don't know, pasta, and he's...
There's a negro in there smashing up with the cave.
I'll make sure he don't touch our special god that we use for the feast.
By the way, isn't it crazy to say that...
Ma che questo ragazzo? Che è venuto qua?
Get in jiggy with it, that I'm never in the mood to hear, even if my team's up by 20 and I'm at a sporting event.
How hot Will Smith
I'm
is.
Never excited to listen to getting jiggy with it, but... That song is better than anything his children have done a million times.
Luke, crank it.
Just because it's just because it's catchy, if nothing else.
But just because you're talented doesn't mean your kids are going to be talented. Judy Garland's the exception, all right? Liza's talented.
Yeah.
Sorry to bring it back.
Oh, but look at that. He was so likable, we let him rap.
Big Willie style is great.
I think he's hot. I love everything about this.
I still love the...
Nah.
Oh, yeah, he won under Grammy.
Yeah, but his son's out there trying to get make like Fellini movies and fucking...
Yeah, it's not... Look at that! Look at that! That's clearly on a soundstage in L.A.
Man, Dancing Like an Egyptian was a hit from the 80s to the 90s. Okay, Will Smith. Alright, there's some naked... Okay. There's some naked men? I see some naked men in there.
Dude, I mean, so he saw this. Jaden must have been watching this as a kid, and he was like, oh, well, Will Smith has an older son that just the two of us
think about. Played football,
but I think he's, like, pretty normal.
Well,
I'm using this, like, sorbet to clear out the Jaden Smith out of my mouth.
And it's still not good enough.
I thought Jaden was the first.
No, he's got an older son from another wife, and that's why they don't talk about it, because it's not a part of Jada.
Yeah. So is Jada the problem? Do you
100%.
Think Jada? Jada used to date Tupac.
Jada Smith is also, well, she's the one who has no talent and a lot of confidence.
Oh.
And then bestowed that, bequeathed that onto her children.
Oh, and Will seems like he's just a dad. Will seems like a dad that can't say
funny?
No.
You know, it's funny, too, and we have talked on the show before, too. She tries to be like, well, I'm not great at anything, so let me go try to do a bunch. And she's a heavy metal singer.
Okay.
Heavy metal band. You know that?
Oh, yes, I do. She screams, yeah.
Ridiculous. But yeah, but it's not like a good band of
good
music. She's terrible.
Of course.
And,
I wouldn't trust her with a plant.
And her acting, her acting's always been like, she's never been like the thing.
Trey Smith, Will Smith's older son, who looks strikingly like, ugly Lenny Kravitz. He's the only...
The Will Smith family is very good looking. I mean, Will is hot and Jada Pinkett Smith. I've always been like I'm saying her name wrong, but she's hot too.
At a time, she was smoking hot.
Remember she wore that wig in Nutty Professor?
Yeah.
It looked like a cancer wig.
Yeah, but he was a star football player and was even offered a scholarship. But instead of going to college, he followed his... Oh, God, he's in music.
No, he's going into music, too?
He's an accomplished DJ. Sure he is.
So is Paris Hilton. What does that say?
Yeah.
Ugh. Oh, so now he's an accomplished DJ.
Oh, there's some songs.
There's a music featuring the two young kids.
Oh, dude, this is a fucking Will Smith family
joint. We only got 3 minutes left.
Play it, Christine. Find You Somewhere. It's
called
ACE.
AIDS. Oh, you're right.
That's the older brother featuring Jaden and Willow.
It's starting out like an Usher video.
Usher.
Is Storm there
like
from X-Men?
You just sent me a text and like,
Storm, mistress of the elements.
Welcome.
Like dog now,
this looks like a dance party that was in eighth grade into someone's basement.
And you're like making out with someone and it braces like, on.
Put on No Doubt again.
Oh, I love No Doubt.
And you thought it was cool, right, you could see smoke going through the light.
What's up, everybody?
Did my butt direct this video? Yeah. Why is it so gay?
That might be the line of the episode. Did my butt direct this episode because it's so gay?
I mean, it's so...
This is the physical manifestation of what gay sex looks like. If gay sex was a music video...
Yeah, I've done this many a time.
Yeah. Can you score a butt fuck?
can you score a butt fuck?
Because let me watch it. You're like, okay. Stead.
And these poor women who have to like dance around. That's the most embarrassing part, is that these accomplished dancers who are like 30 years old have to listen to the kid Smith family.
And he's fucking had to, and like Jaden Smith, like he believes he's been nailing it at music for fucking years.
He's also a genius.
He's a child rapping about adult relationships, which is very frustrating.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, baby girl,
you're not there for me no more. You're like, you're in the eighth grade.
The only thing he can think about is how great his nanny cooks.
Yeah, he's like, I like it when dad lets me stay up late.
I need you here to open some jars.
I'm not allowed.
PB&J.
They put a lock on the basement door because there's a wet bar downstairs. I'm not allowed to put a drink on the pool table. They get mad. Oh, here's Willow's. Do I turn
like
it up?
Willow's. Is this still the song?
Yeah.
It sounds like a different song.
The best is when they had that interview where he's like, I write my own books, and then I go back and I read them 6 months from now, and they're my favorite.
I feel like you said that.
That's right.
You're like, you're a fucking dick.
I write my own books, go back and read them. I fucking forgot about that.
I write my own books and go back and read it. Jaden Smith, if newborn babies could speak, they would be the most intelligent beings on planet Earth.
No, they wouldn't. They would shit their pants and scream for a tit.
Yeah, that's like when people say, like, those movies come out where they're like, we've developed a technology where you can use 100% of your brain. You're like, you're not supposed to use 100% of your brain, or else you'd be having memories shitting, coming, and fucking...
Yeah, you'd be dead.
And also freaking out. Oh,
I vote we sterilize.
Oh. Guys, I'm using 100% of my brain. Oh.
I say we sterilize them. Let's sterilize them with children.
Is that what Britney's doing? Using 100% of her brain? Because she looks a lot like that.
The fluids coming out of the sides. Mateo Lane, thank you.
Guys, thanks so much for having me on the show.
Make sure you go check out Mateo tomorrow night. That's Thursday, June 15th at 9:30 p.m. at Caroline's. Get your tickets before the show. Fill that place up for him. Let him know when you see there you heard him on the Bonfire. He's absolutely hilarious. Check that out. Of course, also, Dan Soder is going to be at the Denver Comedy Works. Woo! Thursday, June 29th through Saturday, July 1st. If you want to fuck Tim Dillon, he'll be at the condo by himself. Get your tickets at dansoder.com.
Also, the Netflix Netflix special coming out July 4th.
Coming out July 4th. Hell yeah.
As part of the series called
Half Hour.
The Stand-Ups. It will be on Netflix. Myself, Nate Bargatze, Fortune Feimster, Dion Cole, Beth Stelling, and Nikki Glaser all have six half-hour comedies, Netflix specials that you can check out. You can check out Big J Oakerson in Poughkeepsie at Laugh It Up this Friday with Zach Amico and Justin Silver. And then June 17th, he's going to be at the West Sloan Springs at the Cherokee Casino West Sloan
this
Springs.
This Saturday.
That's in Oklahoma. So if you're in the Oklahoma
Mike Finoy's going to be with me too, so come check that out.
So go to BigJComedy.com to get all those tickets. We love you guys. Thanks for listening.
Follow us, Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. And Skankfest coming real soon, everybody. Catch you next week. Crackle, crackle.